Hey, Kirk here for Twin Cities Naturalist. Will Stuffed Stanley, the taxidermied groundhog, see a shadow today? We're going to find out. Well, here it is. As you can see, Stanley is casting quite a long shadow on the ground. That means 6 more weeks of winter. But really? 6 more weeks of winter because of a shadow of a groundhog? Why do we even say that? It turns out there's 2 kernels of truth to the whole thing about the groundhog on February 2nd. Groundhogs do actually wake up, the males do, in springtime to look around and kind of see what their territory is looking like, but they're not going to do it on February 2nd. Not here in Minnesota. It's still too cold. They may do that later on in the springtime. So there is some truth to the groundhog kind of getting up and looking around. But what's this deal with the shadow? Why would the groundhog shadow have anything to do with how long winter is? Well, that's where the second kernel of truth is. You see, he saw his shadow today because of the clear blue sky. You see, in order to have a shadow, you have to have a clear sky in order to get that sunlight to make the shadow. Clear sky in the winter indicates a high pressure system that's coming from Canada, bringing with it cold air. Those high pressure systems tend to stick around for a while. So if on February 2nd we've got a clear sky like this, it could tend to indicate that that kind of weather pattern is going to stick around and it's going to keep being cold. At least that's where this idea came from. How reliable is it? I don't know. I think I'll stick with the weather forecast. But there is another place we can look aside from up, and that's down at where the shadow is. Take a look around at this farm field. There's hardly any snow on it. We're here on February 2nd and we don't have much snow cover. I think looking at the ground under the groundhog shadow tells us more about what's going to happen with the rest of the winter than looking at the shadow itself and whether or not it's even there. If there's snow on the ground, it's going to reflect a lot of the sun's heat back up into space. If we don't have much snow, the ground is going to absorb that heat and we're going to end up getting warmer and warmer every day. The sun is a lot more intense now. We are halfway between the winter solstice and the spring equinox. Not much snow now could indicate spring is going to come a little bit earlier than a heavy snowfall, which would have to melt off before we can really warm up. Is it a perfect guess? Not really. It's probably better than looking at a groundhog shadow. So the groundhog says 6 more weeks of winter. This year I'm saying spring's coming early. Thanks for watching, everybody.